Welcome back, everyone. I'm here in my home office, and it's because I'm going to be demoing for you some new software today called Evoto.AI, and they have in fact sponsored today's video. And if you want to try out the software, just click on the link in the description and you'll get 40 free credits. This will allow you to retouch and demo the software and allow you to retouch 40 images free of charge. Their software is great for batch editing images. So maybe you're batch editing photos for a headshot client. You just want to get in there and clean them up a little bit. Maybe you shot an entire office and you've got selects for 40 different people. This software would be great for giving those photos a little bit of polish. Maybe you'd like to pre-touch, if you will, just sort of do some across the board retouching for photos for a headshot or maternity client or something like that, maybe a boudoir client, and you want to just go in there and do some skin retouching and some skin smoothing and stretch mark removal and all of that stuff. You can do that with the AI software, and it takes very little time to accomplish. The third thing that might be of interest to you is a few years ago for my headshot clients, I started offering an upgrade that was all the images in medium or high resolution. And I'm starting to think perhaps I could offer them those images retouched by AI for even a higher amount than I'm currently charging them for just the JPEGs color corrected out of the camera. So let's hop in here and start using the software. So I've got this image of Daniel here, and you'll see over on the left-hand side, there are all these presets that come with the program. You can also generate your own preset if you like. I'm going to go ahead and show you what it looks like when you use a preset first, and then I'll walk you through the process and see what it would be like if you developed your own preset. So let's say in your workflow, you could pull up an image. You could go through there and correct it, and then you could apply all those corrections to all of the images and output them all in a batch. Or you could just use the preset and be fine with that, but probably maybe you're gonna want some fine tuning. I'm using a Mac Studio, which is a very fast computer, and so once I press the preset button, it's going to apply really quickly, just like that. I did also try out the software on my 2019 MacBook Pro, and it was very quick. It just wasn't as fast as the Mac Studio, which of course is to be expected. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on Natural 2 over here and let it do its thing. I'm pressing the button right now, and it's done. So if I zoom in here to 50%, if I go into 100, it's gonna be way too big on the screen. You'll see what it looks like here after. Here's the before, and here's the after. So you can see that it cleaned up a lot of things really quickly all on its own. I'm gonna go ahead and reset the preset here, and I'm gonna walk you through each of the tools one at a time. So over here, you can see that it has figured out that we have a male face. It did that all on its own. Then I'm gonna go ahead and grab the face, freckle, and acne removal tool. And I'm gonna slide that all the way to the right. And you're gonna see that take off many of the blemishes. If you wanted to, there also is this face mole removal tool. But for the most part, I wouldn't suggest, well, culturally, I wouldn't use it because usually we want to keep the moles in place. We just want to take away the blemishes. So that's there if you feel like you'd like it. Then coming down to the next thing, we could adjust the forehead wrinkles, but I don't really see that he has many. We could go to the eye wrinkles here, and I'm just going to pull that up to 60%, and we'll see that those lines just went all the way away. We could pull up the dark circles as well. It's just gonna brighten up under his eyes a little bit. I'm gonna pull it up a little bit more. That looks pretty good to me. The next tool we have here are the smile fold lines. I don't really see a lot on him, so I'm gonna leave that alone. Then coming down here to neck wrinkles, this is one thing that I always normally like to take out, so I'm gonna pull that up to about, well, about 75% there, and I see those lines went right away. He doesn't have a double chin, so we don't need to use that tool. Then I'm gonna open up the skin retouching here. I'm gonna open up the magic face skin dodge and burn slider. I'm gonna apply that, and we'll see what that looks like. There, we've instantly taken care of a lot of things. There, I'm gonna reset it just so you can see the before, and then I'm gonna pull it up again. So you'll see that sort of take care of itself. You can smooth the skin a little bit if you want to, but I think he looks pretty good. We're also using really soft light here, so there isn't too much to do. If we wanted to, we could also do the body skin smoothing. So we might smooth out his neck a little bit. That feels pretty good. And we could use the skin unifying tool here a little bit, which would bring his face and neck a little closer together. That feels pretty good. Now, if we wanted to, there are all these face reshaping tools in here. I don't think I'm gonna use any of them on him. I think he looks pretty good just the way that he is. And I think this looks pretty good overall. We could really change the face a lot if we wanted to. We could also whiten the teeth here. I'm gonna go into 100% just to take a look at that. His teeth are very white. So if I pull that up, you can see that that slider does make them probably way too bright. So I'm just gonna turn that off for now. We could also make his eyes brighter. Let's have a look at that. I think we could do that just to make his eyes and teeth a little more similar. And I think that feels pretty good. There are some makeup settings here, but we're not gonna need them for him. And I think that's gonna feel pretty good overall. I'm gonna look at a female model next, so just hold on for that. The other thing that's in here, I'm gonna look at a before and after really quick. Yep, that looks good. All right, I just wanted to make sure that I didn't go too far. Maybe I'll make one more check on that. So here's before. And here's after. I'm gonna reduce what I did to the eye lines a little bit here. I think I went in a little too much. So I'm just gonna reduce that from 71 down to 40. And maybe that will look a little bit better. So here's before and here's after. Okay, maybe we'll bring the eye wrinkles up just to 50 and we'll call that a day. So before, and then after. Okay, I think that's fine. Now we're gonna go over to the next tool here that I wanna show you, and that is the background tool, or all of the background adjustments, if you will. So if this was a paper backdrop, I could clean it up. I'll show you that a little bit later on a future photo, on our third example here. I can change the headshot background to anything that I want. So let's say that Daniel said, you know, I don't really want that gray background. Could you make it red? I would just click this button and it would be red, just like that. And you can see here at 100% what the edges look like. You can still see detail on the edges of his hair, and it looks really good overall. I'll zoom back out here. You could change it to anything you want. It could be blue, it could be blue solid, it could be blue with a gradient. You can go through all of these options and find the one that works best for you. But let's go ahead, we'll just go with that red one for now, and we'll say that's it. And the good thing that we can do next is we can just copy these adjustments. We'll say this is exactly what we want. We'll just go to Command C, and then I'll click on all the other images, and we'll go to Command V. And it's processing them all. And one more, and they're all done. So there, we processed those 7 images. And now you can see, clicking through here, they all look great, and they are ready to go. All right, so let's pull up this image of Sunna, and we'll go through here, and we'll make adjustments one at a time. So I'm gonna zoom in here to 50% just so we can see what's going on. I'm gonna go back over here to the face tool. And by the way, there are other things in here. You could do your color correcting if you wanted to in the software. I just process these in Capture One. It's my preferred workflow and it's what I like to do. So just know that that is available if you want to use this software and this software only, but I'm working with TIFF files from Capture One. So let's go ahead and we'll take care of all of the face freckles and acne here, and we'll pull that off. Now we're also going to look at the body blemish removal tool. Let's zoom out just so you can see what's going on here with the shot. I'm going to pull it up. And it's done its thing. So we've gotten some correction there. I'm just going to give you a before and an after so you can see how it's retouched her skin. I'm going to come down now to the eye wrinkles. I'm going to pull that up to 50%. We'll watch the software do its thing. Well, let's say 67%, 66%. We'll pull the dark circles up some. Why don't we go all the way on that? Okay, now we're going to just look at those neck wrinkles. That looks pretty good. I think we're fine here. Now let's look at the Magic Face Dodge and Burn tool. I'm going to pull that all the way up. Wow, that really did take care of most of the things in the shot. Now we'll go for some skin smoothing. We'll just pull it up a little bit more here. That looks great. Some body skin smoothing as well. Then I'm going to unify the skin tone a little bit here between the body and the face. I think that looks great. We're going to skip all of those face morphing things, if you will. If we wanted to whiten her teeth a little bit, we could just pull that slider up just like that. I think that's good. We'll brighten her eyes up a little bit here to match. And then here is where it gets rather interesting. I'm going to pull the highlights all the way up on the makeup, and I'm going to pull the contour up to the extreme. This is almost like having a second dodge and burn layer, and so that looks pretty cool to me. Now, if we wanted to, we could change the eye makeup brightness right here in the software. Or we could just leave it alone. We could also use all of these presets here to change her makeup style if we wanted to. And we could even add freckles in this tool right here. I'm gonna go ahead and leave the makeup alone, but just know that that is an option and something that you could do in the program if you were interested in doing it. Or if you had one of those picky headshot clients who said to you that they wanted to change their makeup after the fact, something that would be very difficult to do in retouching, it's pretty simple here in the program. So I think that works out pretty well. Let's go ahead now and see what it looks like with the before and after. So here is the before and here is the after. And again, if I wanted to, I could copy these adjustments and apply it to all the other photos that I have right here. I want to show you one last thing, and I think it's pretty cool. If you're shooting on a white seamless, a lot of the times, you'll end up with this situation where you're going to have a lot of footprints and you got to clean that up somehow. So we've got this photo of Jason here. I'm going to go to 100% and come down here to the very bottom, and I'm just going to come over to the background tab over here, and I'm just going to click on this box that says clean solid backdrop and watch it do its thing. And there we go. So instantaneously it has taken out all of those footprints. Here's the before, here's the after. If you think it's too much, you can just grab this slider right here and pull it back a little bit. Maybe that's where we'd like to be instead. Here it is full frame. Here's the after. Here's the before. And here's the after. So as you can see from the demo that I did today of the software, this is really going to speed up your workflow and help you polish your images a lot faster. It also could give you something more that you could sell to your clients if you want to sell this batch edit of AI retouched images in JPEG form. Just maybe something to think about. The software costs about 6 cents per image. It's a little different model than you're used to. You buy credits, and then you can use those credits to process the photos. And if you click on the link in the description, you'll get 40 credits, and that will allow you to retouch 40 images and try out the software. So thank you so much for your time. Stay safe, have a great day, and I'll talk to you soon.